I told you a fact is a fact. If the essence in the translated form is true, it won't change. Look, people give speeches. You see, in politics, there are people who are giving speeches and translation at the same time is being translated in the audience. Everybody is hearing this guy saying this and this guy. There is no confusion because the speech is transferred. The same time, somebody asks in English, and the other person is a German fellow. German says this guy is asking this question, and the German answers. He says in Russian. He listens to the question and he answers the.
Throughout
the world, all languages are being spoken, so no problem. So what I am trying to convey is that when Quran, when Allah's ayahs, essence, the spirit is transferred into any other language. So Allah says that is Arabi Mubin. That's the clear Arabic language. Means the spirit is clear. No difference. So Ajmi wa Arabi. What Arabic and non-Arabic? Qul huwa lilladheena amanu. Say for those who believe, hudam wa shifa. Meaning a person who doesn't speak Arabic language, he has understood the essence in a translated form. And if he believes, it's a guidance and a healing to him. It's a guidance and healing for him. Walladina, a person who speaks Arabic language, he can understand the Quran in Arabic because he speaks Arabic language, but he doesn't believe. So it is not a guidance to him. So you can see there are Arabs, Jews, they are Arabs, Christians, they are Arab atheists, they are Arab Buddhists, because they are human beings. So it is the criteria laid down by Allah is belief. When the essence is translated in a non-Arabic language, and a person who believes in that, so it's a guidance for a healing for that person, whether he speaks Arabic language, whether he doesn't speak Arabic language. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ فِي آذَانِهِمْ وَقْرٌ وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِمْ عَمًى. And those for who believe not, there is a deafness in their ears, and over them is blindness, and they are those who are being called from a distant place. And those who do not believe, whether he's an Arab, whether he's a non-Arab, Ajam, non-Arab, I mean he speaks Arabic language or not, he doesn't speak Arabic language. If he does not believe, the spirit transferred into another language, he does not believe. So it is, he says, there's a deafness in his ears. And there's blindness, as if he's called from a far distant place. But a person who believes, whether he's an Ajam, non-Arabic person, he understood the spirit in his language. So if he believes, it's a guidance and healing and mercy. Ashura 26, 198 and 199. وَلَوْ نَزَّلْنَاهُ عَلَىٰ بَعْضِ الْأَعْجَمِينَ فَقَرَأَهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ مُؤْمِنِينَ. And we have revealed it, the trustworthy spirit, over some non-Arabic people or personal languages. Then he had read it over them, they would have not been the believers with it. This ayah is only referring that if the Quran was revealed in some other languages or non-Arabic people, non-Arabic language, and if he would have read it on the people, still people do not believe. The matter is that the revelation came down in the Arabic language. I've told you before, bilisanin arabi mubin, with the Arabic language. The spirit comes with the Arabic language. Nazala bihi ruhul amin, revealed the trustworthy spirit. With the over your heart, so that you warn, with the Arabic language. So Arabic language cannot be excluded, but once by the Arabic language and the spirit has come, it will come in a translated form, in a different language of the world, any language of the world. So that means the revelation is always in Arabic. The language chosen by Allah is Arabic. So Arabic language of the Quran, and the spirit of the Quran, the sentence of the Quran, the ayahs of the Quran, the Arabic, when delivered in a different language, and if the spirit comes, the language becomes same, then there is no difference. Whether you speak Arabic or don't speak, you believe, it's a guidance and a healing. But Allah did not reveal, like some people say, well, before it was revealed in Hebrew. The Bible doesn't say, but you people are saying it. There is not a single verse in the Bible that God said, I revealed the Bible in Hebrew or Aramaic. People say the Bible is in Aramaic or Hebrew. There is not a book on this planet Earth which claims that this language was revealed by God or what. It is only in the Quran Allah explained the language problem or the ayahs revealed in what language. So the Jews or the Christians say, the Jews say that the Old Testament was revealed in Hebrew and the New Testament only Greek. Not, it is existing in that language, doesn't mean it was revealed by God. It, Allah said never. He never revealed other than Arabic. And why Arabic? Because it's a detailed language, not because of the Arabs. Now, but Arabic is because Fusar, detailed language. So in another further ayah, you have to understand the Arabic should be make as a criteria or judge. That is what it says, Ar-Rooh 13 and 37. وَكَذَلِكَ أَنزَلْنَاهُ حُكْمًا عَرَبِيًّا وَلَئِنِ اتَّبَعْتَ أَهْوَاهُمْ بَعْدَ مَا جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ مَا لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا وَاقٍ. And likewise we reveal it in Arabic, hukum, governance. That is to govern. If you follow their vain desires after the knowledge has come to you, then for you there will be neither a protector nor a guard from Allah. So that means I am telling you, Arabic language is chosen by God is because a detailed language. So it says you have to govern. The hukum is from Allah in Arabic. So how would you know that I am speaking correct or wrong? I am reading the text of the Arabic language of Allah, not the text of Arabic man, somebody Arab wrote or something. What Allah wrote in the ayahs, the Arabic text, so that is the hukum or the governance, so that you can govern when somebody is giving a translation. You can govern from the Arabic. Always you can check up from the Arabic text written by Allah. So Allah says, وَكَذَلِكَ أَنزَلْنَاهُ حُكْمًا عَرَبِيًّا. The language, hukum, governed for governance is Arabic. So that is why the revelation is in Arabic language, because the mufassalat, fussilat, the detailed language, it's a detailed language. So that is why Allah says the governance is with the Arabic, of the Quran, not of the Arabic speaking people, because their language is a human language, like us, like non-Arabs. Because their spirit is like our spirit. This is the spirit of Allah. Their words are like our words. You understand what I'm saying? Any person speaking anything is transferring each other's spirit. But when you read Allah's ayahs, that's Allah's spirit we are talking about. So Arabic text of Allah's ayahs, you have to govern by that. Governance. And if you follow their vain desire after the knowledge has come to you, then for you they will be neither a protector or a helper. Surah Al-Baqarah 2, Ayah 97 and 98. قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوَّا لِجِبْرِيلَ فَإِنَّهُ نَزَّلَهُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَهُدًى وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوَّا لِلَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ وَجِبْرِيلَ وَمِيكَالَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَدُوَّا لِلْكَافِرِينَ. Say, who is the enemy for Jibreel? Say, surely he is revealed. It is he who is revealed over your heart with the permission of Allah, confirming what is between his two hands and a guidance and a good news for believers. So I told you the big name, that Jibreel is the name of the Ruhul Qudus and Ruhul Amin. And Ruhul Qudus is Holy Spirit. And Ruhul Amin is trustworthy spirit. So who is the enemy of the Jibreel? Mean who is the enemy of the Ruhul Amin and Ruhul Qudus? Mean the Holy Spirit and the trustworthy spirit. Enemies you don't accept, you don't believe, you reject, and you disrespect the essence, the truth, the trustworthy spirit or the Holy Spirit of Allah if you profane. So Allah says, who is the enemy of Jibreel? You are actually being the enemy of Jibreel. So Allah says, who is the enemy of Jibreel? Surely he is revealed over your heart. Over? Ala qalbika. Bi-iznillah. With the permission of Allah. Musaddiqan lima bayna yadayhi. So that you can, confirming what is between his two hands. You can confirm. and a guidance and a good news for the believers. So Jibreel is referred here as it is he who is being revealed. People think it's an angel, but in the following ayat you see man kana adubu lillahi wa malaikati wa rusulihi wa jibrila wa mikaila fa inna Allah adubu lil kafirin. Say, who is the enemy for Allah and for the angels and for the messengers and for Jibreel and for Mikal? So angels are separated from Ruhul Aminul Qudus or Jibreel. So people have this misconception that Jibreel is an angel. He's not an angel. He is Ruhul Qudus. He is Ruhul Amin. He is the trustworthy spirit. He is the Holy Spirit, a messenger from Allah, which was sent to Maryam also, peace be upon her. So similarly here, and sent to even Muhammad, peace be upon him. But it is always, you must understand, it is the essence, the spirit. Because it says, who is the enemy for Jibreel or for Allah, for Malaika, separate angels, and Rasul, messengers, and Jibreel, separate, angels separate, Jibreel separate, and mention the ayahs. And wherever you see in the Quran, Malaika, you'll see Ruh. The Malaika and Ruh. So Ruh, we understand that we are discussing the Ruh, the Spirit, is from Allah. And that is Jibreel. And it is the Holy Spirit, mean Ruhul Qudus. It is Ruhul Amin, the trustworthy Spirit. And Surah Taha 20 and Ayah 25 and 26 and 27. Qala Rabbi Shali Sadri وَيَسِلْ لِي أَمْرِي وَأَحْلُ الْأُغْضَةً مِنْ لِسَانِي يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي. He, that is Musa, is referred here, said, O my Lord, expand my chest for me and make my task easy for me and open the knot from my language so that they may understand what I say. So Musa salam is asking Allah to expand his chest and make my task easy for me. His task was to deliver the message to the Firaun in the Quran. He was there to deliver the message to Firaun. So he's asking Allah before his deliverance to the Firaun, the Pharaoh. So he's asking, oh my Lord, open my chest, expand my chest for me and make my task easy for me. And his task was to deliver the message of Allah. So he says, and open the knot from my language. Now people say that he used to stutter. No. He has to deliver the message in the language of the people. He has to deliver the message in the language of the people. So he has to transfer the spirit of Allah in the language of the people. So he's asking his, open the knot from my language, so that they may understand what I say. And he was to deliver the message of Allah to the Firaun. And we are listening all the time the Arabic text and the translation form. In all parts of the world, you have to speak in the language of the people. Otherwise, how can be so many Muslims in the world? It is always in the language of people. So he's asking Allah to open the knot of my language, what I speak. So he may speak any language, but he has to deliver with the Arabic text. With the Arabic text and the clarification in the language of the people. Arabic text with the clarification in the language of people, he has to translate. So he's asking Allah to open the knot from my language so that they may understand what I say, so that people could understand what he's trying to deliver. So this is the dua of Musa salam. Similarly, similarly, I'm just trying to explain this concept that the translation or the explanation is in the language of the people. It says in Surah Maryam 19 and 97, and there is one more ayat also, but I've just referred to one. فَإِنَّمَا يَسَّنَّاهُ بِلِسَانِكَ لِتُبَشِّرَ بِهِ الْمُتَّقِينَ وَمْتُنْدِرَ بِهِ قَوْمَ الْلُدَّةِ. So surely we have made it easy with your language so that you give good news with it to those who guard, and you warn with it to those people who are fiercely quarrelsome. So if you look, فَإِنَّمَا يَسَنَّاهُ بِلِسَانِكَ, we have made it easy, what, the spirit, with your language. So the language of a human being is always not what Allah's spirit is. The language what we speak, we are transferring our spirit. So Allah says, we have made it the spirit easy in your language, with your language, so that you may give good news to those who guard, and you warn with it, with the spirit, to those people who are fiercely quarrelsome. Again, you understand, you must understand, any person speaking any language, his language is his language, and whatever he speaks is his words. But once he has to speak the message of Allah, he can only speak when Allah has revealed the essence, the spirit, in his language. The spirit of Allah revealed in the language of the person. So Musa Islam is also asking, open the knot of my language. So his language is human language. And when he speaks the message of Allah, it is always with the Arabic language, translated and clarified in the language of the people. And once the spirit is transferred in the language of people, people say it is this human talking. They disrespect their essence or profane that essence. So now what I was all the time saying is based on this ayah, Ibrahim 14 and 4. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ فَيُضِلُّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. And we have not sent from any messenger to clarify for them except with the language of his people. So Allah strays to whom he wills and guidance to whom he wills, and he's powerful the wise. So now you will be clear what I was all the time saying. He says Allah has not sent any messenger except to clarify for the people in their language. In the language of the people. The messenger is receiving the message in Arabic. The Allah's words is in Arabic. Bilisanin Arabi Mubin. With the Arabic language, the messenger clarifies in the language of the people. The language of the people will always be in other than Arabic. Whether the Arab speaking people or the non-Arab speaking people. But the revelation of Allah is Quranic Arabic, is Arabic. When its spirit is clear to someone, he will speak in the language of the people. That spirit. Always, in all times. So this is what says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِ. We have not sent from any messenger to clarify for them except with the language of the people. It is always with the language of the people. Arabic, the translation essence, whether Quranic Arabic and the Arabic speaking people, there is also translation. They have to use their language. But the spirit is always clarified with the language of the people. So people understand, or people believe in their language, transferred of the spirit of Allah in their language. In their language. And this is how there are so many Muslims, non-Arabic speaking Muslims in the world. How they believe? How they believe? Even here today also, at this very moment, we are not Arabic speaking. You understand Arabic language here, people? We don't understand. So we are trying to understand in a language which we can understand. So the same is that is the principle laid down by Allah. Always in the language of the people is being transferred, and once it's transferred, people try to say this is he talking. Those who have got doubts. So that is what I say is, we have not sent from any messenger to clarify for them except with the language of his people. So Allah strays to whom he wills and guides to whom he wills, and he's powerful wise. People who believe, Allah guides, and people who listen to the translated form, the spirit essence of Allah's ayahs, who does not believe, he has strays. Because it is always in a translated form in the other language to be clarified by the messengers. And in all times in the sunnah of the messengers, every human being whom Allah speaks, He has to clarify with the language of the people. He cannot clarify in Arabic only. But He will speak Arabic, use the Arabic language, Arabic, Quranic Arabic, and then He translate and try to explain the essence that if He has received. And that is only the way. There is no other way. That how Allah communicates to human being. And in the end, I end my lecture or talk. This is a dua or the call of Ibrahim al-Islam. Ashura 26, 83 and 84. Rabbi habli hukmum wal hiqni bis salihin waj'alli lisana sidqin fil akhirin. Ibrahim said, My Lord, grant for me governance and join me with those who correct themselves, and for me make language truthful in others. Ibrahim al-Islam is saying that make for me the language truthful in others. Whenever Allah's ayat or essence is delivered to Ibrahim al-Islam and when he spoke to mankind, so make it easy or truthful in others so that people can trust in a translated form. They understand that it is the Allah's ayat, essence coming from Allah. So whenever a person delivers a message in a language of the people, people can doubt and say this is human talking. So how can it be truthful when you have to pray to Allah? That Ibrahim Musa says, open my not from my language. Ibrahim says, Waj'alli lisana sidqin, make for me the language truthful fil akhirin in others. So I end this talk by just summarizing the spirit of Allah is in the book of Allah. Whenever you read the book of Allah, you must understand there are different topics discussed all the time in the book of Allah. So you have to select a subject from, if you want to understand the Quranic ayahs, you can read from the beginning to the end all the time. But once you want to identify a subject in your mind, then you have to collect the ayahs from different surahs and chapters, and then you have to ponder on those ayahs. And by the help of Allah, the places of the ayahs are exchanged. And then you get the spirit of Allah. And that spirit is Qul Nazalahu Ruhul Qudus. Defined by Allah as the Holy Spirit. Or as the trustworthy spirit of Allah's ayats. Translated in a language. And that language is any other language of the Arabic, Quranic Arabic. And that language you trust, because it is containing the essence of Allah's words in Arabic. So in other words, that is the Arabic language. So Allah says that language, Arabic language and non-Arabic language becomes almost same when the spirit is transferred. And that Arabic spirit has to come from Allah. So you can trust and believe it is coming from Allah. And it's a holy spirit, trustworthy spirit and holy. You can have confidence and you believe, and those who believe, it's a guidance and a healing. And those who do not believe, there's a deafness in their ears, and as if people, it is being called from a distant far off. Thank you.